So this is the Sound Box Guitars Finish It Yourself Cigar Box Guitar Kit. The kit comes with everything you need to finish a cigar box guitar. You will be playing this guitar within a couple of hours of opening the kit. Got everything you need, including the neck, all the nuts and bolts, strings, even a slide to get you going on this. So check it out.
You get a nice cigar box. They'll vary depending on availability, but it'll be a nice box and it comes with a lot of stuff. First, you got a couple of support blocks, which we'll glue in place later. A couple of screws to fasten it all together. Some miscellaneous hardware, nuts and bolts that make up the bridge and the nut of the guitar, along with some tuning keys and screws. You get a set of strings, three strings, some string trees, and some string holders that go through the neck. You'll get a custom beer bottle glass slide to go with it. Most importantly, you will get the neck of the guitar, which I have cut out the notch for the box, drilled the holes, cut out your headstock, drilled the pilot holes for the string trees, as well as the tuning hardware. This thing is ready to go. And last but not least, a sticker and a CD from the Budros, 100% foot stomping cigar box rock and roll. Let's get to it. Step number one, notching out the box. This is where the neck is going to fit out. I made the lines for you. You just need a small little saw. I use a pull saw, or you can use a utility knife if you wish. Stay just to the insides of those two lines for a tight fit. We're going to go over that later. I score the horizontal line. Score it a few times, kind of as deep as you can. You don't necessarily need to punch all the way through, but just score it a few times. This will give it a breaking point. I'm going to open the box and just score along the inside too, so it gives it somewhere to snap off. Wiggle that piece, should snap right out. You'll be left with a little rough spot, but we're going to clean that up later on when we fit the neck. Step two is putting in the support blocks we're going to fasten the neck to. These little pre-cut blocks fit right in there underneath the cuts you just made. You're going to fasten it with some wood glue or some white glue and stick it into place, squeeze it. If you got a clamp, put a spring clamp on it, wipe the glue clean, and get the neck ready while this is drying. Step three is finishing the neck, and you're going to want to file out or sand out any rough spots. You also can get this ready for painting or staining. I hit it with a sander, some 120 grit. You can decide how far you want to go with it as far as staining or painting, but customize it, make it yours. Hit the ends of it, hit the faces of it, hit the corners, smooth it out. Make it look good. Step four is fret markers. Grab your fret marking guide, line up the nut with the center of that V groove, and start marking down here. First fret, second fret, third fret, and so on. Until you get down to the 12th fret, you're going to flip the page over, line up 12th fret with the mark you just made, and continue marking down. I put 17 on my guitar here, but you can go down as far as the scale takes you. Get some kind of straight edge, or I use a little miter box here, and just lightly cut through your paint job or stain job, whatever you've done. Cut down the neck till you get all your fret markers cut out there, and you should have a finished product of fret markings all the way down the neck. Step five. String trees and tuners. Get your little string trees out and pound them into the pilot holes I drilled for you. Do all three. Next, you're going to get your tuners. You put these in through the backside. There's little screw hole pilot holes already for you. Tighten them down, two for each tuner. Do that for all three tuners. You should have a finished headstock that looks like this. Step six, fitting the neck. Grab a file or a utility knife, sandpaper, smooth out the notch to get your neck to fit in there nice and snug. The box is going to close down over it. When you get a good fit, you're ready to finish this thing up. Step 7 is making a sound hole. I use a little center punch and a hole saw to cut out a sound hole. This lets the bass response out of the box. You can cut F holes or any other style that you like. Put a little trim piece on if you wish. Finish it up a bit. Step 8 is putting it all together. Get yourself a small little bit to drill a pilot hole down into the support blocks. Maybe a half inch or so. Doesn't need to be too deep into the block. Do this on both sides. There's a couple of drywall screws. You're gonna put those down through the countersunk holes in the top. Just tighten it up. You don't need to twist on it too hard, just snug it up. You're pulling the box and the neck down to the support blocks to keep it tight. And here's where you have your basic finished guitar ready for stringing up. Step 9, stringing the guitar. Put these strings through these little nuts, which are the string holders. They go in through the back of the guitar, heaviest string on top, working its way down. You're going to pull it through, and this is going to brace the string against the back of the neck. The strings I use are D'Addario in XL set, and I use the gauges 36, 26, 17, working its way down. I feel that's good for tuning an open G or open A. You're going to take the strings up underneath the string trees, and you're going to wrap around the tuning key. I do from the outside here on this bottom string. Wrap it around a couple of twirls, put it through the hole, tighten it up a little bit. Do that with all three strings. If you have some other way to string it up, by all means use it. This is my way. For the center one, you go around the bottom to loop it as well. For the heaviest string, or the top string here, I go around the outside, so the top part of the tuning peg, wrap around and put it back through. Put a little tension on the strings and then slide the nut underneath here. I'm going to use a pencil to put a little bit of graphite in the groove here, and that helps to lubricate the string as it's being tuned up, sliding through here. Tighten up a little bit, then we're going to get on down to the bridge once there's a little tension on the strings. So with the bridge, same thing, just lift up on the strings a little bit, slide it under to its approximate mark, put a little bit of graphite in the slots there so you can tune it up. Now this is ready to tune. Thanks for watching the Soundbox Guitars Finish It Yourself Cigar Box Guitar Kit tutorial. Hopefully you got everything together, up and running, and you're making some Cigar Box Guitar swampy sounds. Soundboxguitars.com. Thanks.